I hear that now they have, like, they'll have, like, theaters where they'll have, like, an artist and a comedian, they'll come.
No.
And they will talk.
That is so L.A.
Yeah.
Several thousand people have heard our speakers, from Eli and Edie Broad themselves to cultural icons such as John Waters, Jeff Koons, and Liz Diller, founding principal of Diller Scofidio Renfro, the architects designing our museum.
So many challenges. There, Los Angeles, right. Grand Avenue, Frank Gehry,
and Eli.
Eli, not a challenge. Eli, come on.
It is fun, and it's broadening, and I like to say I'd be bored to death if I spent all my time with other business people, lawyers, and accountants, and bankers.
Early on in my career, I started using these little end papers that came from the hair salon. I could experiment with them because they were 50 cents a box. And so this idea of rapid speed and working out ideas through the material, I could afford to.
I'm not saying all artists should be activists, by the way. I really don't mean that. And I don't think all art should have, you know, any kind of direct relationship to political reality. But I'm just curious whether can we be so immune?
So if we could look at 19 at the big balloon dog. Now, is this sexual? Because basically, the dog's neutered. I mean, the only way it's going to reproduce is on a plate. A limited edition one.
And I've also always thought that the balloon dog, it's a little bit like a Trojan horse, you know, and it's reminds me of another type of Trojan, too, that you could use to make the balloon dog.
When I see my movie, every time I cry myself.
This question will make you happier then. Where can I buy your hat?
The life of a painting depends on the intimacy with which somebody, you know, continues to look and figure out all of the decision making that went into that painting.
I really wish I could do that. I envy you.
Yeah, do what, paint?
No, sell something to Eli. But...
I think I prefer approaching Rembrandt through this than through the actual Rembrandts. Rembrandts I like to look at, of course, but I just feel like I just feel so bad about myself after I've looked at them.
Yeah. What about brushes?
Well, we don't have enough time, but I'm right now. You shouldn't have asked me that question.
Should we tell people what a subtlety is? Because
sure.
I was fascinated by that.
So before this was a sphinx. It was like, what is an idea that can? What is something, an object that contains the idea of ruins, and spectacle, and civilization, and slavery that everybody knows, whether or not they've seen it,
right.
And I was like, oh, Sphinx, you know, Sphinx. And it was just like a little glimmer of an idea. It seemed kind of silly. It actually still seems pretty silly.
And our mission's very simple. We want our art shown to the broadest possible audience, whether it's in our building or various museums in this state and throughout the world.